changing his behavior. He said that it was so significant that even Yah found it a precious beauty. No doubt this was the beauty that Boaz saw in Ruth, the purity of heart that caused him to admire her so much. It glowed through her worn-out clothing for all to see. I love this. Says, second, this kind of beauty reveals the heart of Yah. It demonstrates his compassion and kindness. It is his desire to build up his people, not to tear them down, to strengthen them, not to sap their strength. It reveals Yah as a joyous, celebrative Elohim who enjoys being with those who seek him with a sincere heart. And you can think about that verse when he says he sings over us as well. So you know he's joyous and celebrated. Hallelujah. Says, third, Boaz's reproduction of Yah's glory unveils the character of Yah as his spirit lives within us, bringing about his transformation. We become people who are truthful, trustworthy, pure, and unselfish. Yahushua HaMashiach told Philip, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. That's in John 14, verse 9. It says, when we have been with Yah, others will see the beauty of his character reproduced in us. They will see his glory in street clothes. Fourth, Boaz's way of revealing Yah's beauty makes others want to know Yah. Most of us can recount incidents we have witnessed or heard about professing believers who have offended and wounded both believers and non-believers. The comment that we often hear says, if that's what it means to be a Christian or a believer, I don't want to be one. It's painful to hear because it means that we're not reflecting Yah's glory to others. It says, attracted to those with tender, open hearts. So they will want to experience what you're experiencing. They wouldn't shun it. Says, no one could be a better example of how to reproduce Yah's beauty than Yahushua HaMashiach and the people who flocked to him. People like Mary Magdalene or Mary from Magdala found a beauty and grace in him that transformed her life. Fifth, the reflection of Yah's beauty that we see in Boaz gives people a sense of security in relationships. When we reflect Yah's beauty according to Torah, it makes us individuals who can be trusted. We become individuals who exhibit the character of our Creator, and others realize that they don't need to fear Him. While it may seem that reflecting Yah's beauty is not a male virtue, Boaz make a powerful case for the beauty that it creates in men. Don't you agree? While both men and women are called to holiness of life, we believe that it is an especially attractive quality in men. We are saying that the men who wants to nurture healthy relationship with women, whether it's his wife, daughter, or woman in general, will want to concentrate on this aspect of his life. Just as this was one of those qualities that draw women to the Messiah, so it will foster those kinds of relationships between men and women and allow them to thrive. And now the rest of the story. So we come to the conclusion of our presentation for today with these next few slides. A few days after the first draft of this chapter was finished, the author stated that he was reading the Psalms and realized that although the psalmist was writing about Yah, the words perfectly described Boaz and the practical ways in which he reproduced the character of Yah. In Psalms 138, verse 2, King Dude writes, I will give thanks to your name for your unfailing love and faithfulness, because your promises are backed by all the honor of your name.
And this is an apt description of Boaz. In the following verse, King Dude says, "You encourage me by giving me the strength that I need." Those words could have come from Ruth's lips in describing Boaz. In Psalm 146, and we read this for our, when we did a reading of the Psalms earlier, Psalm 146, King Dude again speaks adoringly of Yah. And we hear an echo of what we have seen in Ruth's rescuer. In verse 7, it says, "He gives food to the hungry." And we know Boaz gave her food. In verse 8, "He lifts up those who are bowed down." And we see that in the story that we just reviewed. In verse 9, Yah watches over alien, and Ruth surely was an alien or a stranger in that land. And he sustained the fatherless and the widows. And we know that she was a widow as well. Boaz was revealing the heart of Yah in his actions towards Ruth and Naomi. These women and those who were watching on the sidelines could observe Yah's passion acted out. It took away the starchiness of religious activity and portrayed righteousness that was attractive and winsome. We are left with the engaging challenge to be like Boaz toward those around us. What an opportunity. Hallelujah. And I think it's beautiful reminders and lessons that we have learned today from the book of Ruth and from the story of Boaz and Naomi and Ruth herself, reflecting on different ways in which we can reflect the character of Yah. Now, do we have any points, any comments, any questions, any answers?
To anything that we have discussed today?
What do you think about Boaz? What do you think about Boaz being called Ruth's rescuer?
I think it's beautiful. I think Yah used people in different ways. And I think he actually did use her I think Yah used Boaz to rescue her and to redeem her and to give her a place of belonging by marrying her and redeeming her also to reflect the Messiah. I think there's a messianic connection there as well between Ruth and Boaz. What were you thinking? Okay, so not a comment? All right, so we will... I thought you had something in mind when that came across. No? All right. Kind of quiet today, but that's fine. If we have another comment, we'll pray and close out. Abba Yahweh, thank you so much for your love towards us. We thank you for calling us out of all the other nations that were among us. You said we weren't more numerous or weren't more mighty or there was nothing special about us, but you chose us to be your peculiar people, your royal nation, a holy priesthood, call for it just to show forth your praises. And so as we leave here today, O Yah, help us that we will continue each day to stay in this constant, beautiful, beautiful covenant relationship with you. And so we will not even try, but we will just automatically reflect your character and your beauty. We love you, Yah. We love ourselves and we love each other. And we praise and magnify you as we ask all these mercies in your name, O Yah, in the name of your Son, Yahushua HaMashiach. Hallelujah.
Thank you. if my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray. And then see my face turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven. I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sin and I'll heal their land. If my people
call by my name,
if they
humble themselves. Can anybody out there pray for me without even knowing what I need? Can anybody out there pray for me, the prayers of the righteous? Can anybody out there pray for me without even knowing a whole lot about me? Can anybody pray where the prayer don't cease, the prayers of the righteous?
Waiting
so patiently for your face to see.
Waiting.